basically, you know, we come from a understanding that knowledge cannot be commercialized to a way that you know, the existing frameworks have commercialized, and that to perpetuate, you know, year after year, to pay to some people for a knowledge that has been created collectively, I think that is something unacceptable. And secondly, that the support system that is needed to, even after paying that kind of money, the support system that is needed to get the process moving is too complicated because of viruses and other problems. So we were firefighting in the sense that there is always some problem that emerges from somewhere and spreads across the system, you know, which creates trouble. So it's for ideological reasons and also for the efficiency reasons. So we thought we will move on to a system that provides one reliable and source of computing, and at the same time the maintenance is limited. You know, TIS uses SPSS in a very big way actually, so we need to move on to that. For time being we are buying about 100 what is that, licenses SPSS. Of SPSS, because you know, it's so very important that we have moved there. We needed the compatible system, but then we would move to R quickly, so that even that part is taken care of. Was it a challenge? We started with the students. We started with the students in the sense that most of our students, about 50% of our students, have their own laptops. So when we configure them and load the
Ubuntu
program, we loaded the open software. Secondly, we have Cyber Library. We moved Cyber Library to Ubuntu. So in the process, what has happened is that we took care of the student community first. And they were quick to learn. It's easier to create systems. But what is more important is that can you support it?
Yes.
You need to use both methods. One is there is an ideology that you need to have a free exchange of knowledge.
Yes.
That is a belief that all of us have. But people have a comfort zone,
yeah.
You know, and. So I think some didn't need any motivation, but some needed motivation, but a few needed force.
Yeah.
The downtime has declined already.
Okay. Well, that you're able to see already.
Downtime has declined already. The loss of your files and, you know, that has reduced. Of course, people can still do mistakes to erase their files, but you know, in terms of loss due to virus, that has declined. And you know, all those monies we spend on buying thousands of antivirus software, you don't need to buy. You know, the licenses which we paid, we don't need to pay. I think you know, 2 years down the line. You would have a much better situation whereby, you know, the institute is fully free from, you know,
malware,
extractive processes which of people employ to that of a free open society. See, you need champions.
Okay.
Okay. So in my case, I brought in senior professors who understood the system absolutely well, okay, and brought in energetic people who are well versed with the system. I think so. You need that backbone.
Mm.
That when you have the backbone where people feel confident, then you would have move smooth actually.
Mm-hmm.
But institutions that depend upon outsiders to provide them the support, then you would have reluctance actually.
Mm-hmm. So if you're able to build support internally and you have a champion along with the young supporters,
yeah, support then... You know, Sally, it is like that. You know, when you came and started motivating us, I think we took about almost 2 years before we actually able to move on to that, because when I saw that it was not changing, I basically dismantled the computer system. You know, I basically dismantled the computer system because the person, I had to change the chairperson, I had to transfer several people out of it. And basically you need to create a new architecture. So if you have people who are unwilling to change, then you have to make hard decisions actually.
Mm. Yeah. The paradox is we are in an environment which is of social change, and we don't see that software change is a part of the same social change.
Absolutely.
So on one hand we are advocating social change for others,
yeah,
and when it comes to ourselves we want to sit in comfort zones and not, you know, look forward to adopting the same change, you know.
I think more education is needed actually, you know.
Mm.
We should have much more better debate in vice chancellor's conferences.
Mm.
You know, I think we need to have far more enlightened debate on this issue, because otherwise we become slaves of this kind of extractive processes actually. So I think my advice to other heads of institutions is that try and identify some good team that can provide you support. Invest upfront some monies.
Mm.
But eventually your maintenance cost will come down so substantially. So
even economically, even if you didn't include philosophy, economically,
yeah,
itself, it's
economically that it makes good sense. To move into this. I suppose people do move into it. Yeah. Thank you.
Thank you very much.
Thank you.
Pleasure.
Yeah.